Hey YouTube, welcome to video number 6 in my little Nix series. In the last video we have transformed our static hyperland configuration into a part of our NixOS system configuration. And in this video I would like to show you how to handle Dotfiles in your home manager environment and show you the different approaches you can take to handle your configuration files. So let's get started. In the last two videos we already kind of configured Dotfiles for our user environment because we had enabled and configured waybar as part of our configuration, and we also included the hyperland configurations. On our virtual machine, the Nix configuration created the Dotfiles in our config folder for waybar here, and the same for hyperland. If you want to build the configuration file for an application, it's very much dependent on the use case and on your personal preference. I am kind of following a mixed approach. So for example, when I have configurations like hyperland that are not changed very often and that need to be shared in parts between different machines, I will always favor Nix over any other kind of configuration file. On the other hand, for example, when it comes to NeoVim, I like to have this in a Dotfiles repo, because when it comes to NeoVim configuration, there are usually multiple configuration files involved, and there are plugins and so on and so forth. So in today's video, I will show you how to create a Git repo we can use as an input to our Nix Flake and use Home Manager to write the configuration for us based on the Git repo. So when we have a look at the Home Manager options for NeoVim, you can see there is a way to configure it in Nix, but as you can see here, this is done with a multiline string, and this is not as flexible to configure like we did in the hyperland example. So I will just move this into a Git repo, and I have created a sample repo you can just clone to follow along. So this repo will basically just include one folder for NeoVim, and that's basically how you would usually store it in your .config folder here. So when I go in here, I have the init.lua, and here I have a subfolder for other configuration. So one way to include this into a Nix configuration is to actually make a Nix package, but that doesn't make very much sense, because when you create Nix packages, you need to exactly define the hash of the commit, and you need to update this all the time. So the way I have chosen to do this is I will take this Git repo, and instead of making a package, we'll use it as an input to my Nix Flake configuration. So that means when I go to my flake.nix file, I have the inputs up here, and now I will just create a new input named Dotfiles here and just use the URL from my Git repo here. And as this is just a regular Git repo and does not contain a Nix flake, I will just set flake equals false, and I also need to add the Dotfiles to the outputs. And the next thing I want to do is I want to get into my user configuration for my username, and I would just create a new folder named Dotfiles, and within that folder I created default.nix, and on the host configuration file for my user I will also import the Dotfiles here. And now I just need to write a little bit of Nix code in order to get our NeoVim configuration in here, so I will just refer to the inputs, and then I will just define home file, and here I define where Nix should put this file or folder, so we will put it in .config nvim, and we will define two attributes here. The first one is source, and here we refer to our input, and we use the subfolder mvim from our Git repo, and we set recursive equals true, and this needs a semicolon. And the recursive equals true just tells Nix that all the files contained in the input .files.nvim, whoops, there's an error, shall be included. And now we can try to rebuild our system configuration. And here you can see that the input was added to our flake.log file. And of course, what I did forget is to add the newly created files to the repo here. So we try again. And now the configuration has been built. And when we go to our virtual machine and just hit clear. And when we have a look at our config folder, you can see we have NeoVim here. And here we have the contents of our Git repo input as part of our Nix store here. So when I enter nvim, you can see this will immediately start to execute my configuration. Of course, it will try to pull all the plugins and so on and so forth that are defined in my NeoVim configuration. So this will take a while. And when all the installation process of the plugin manager of NVim is finished, I just need to exit it and just start it again. And you can see that NeoVim looks a little bit different now. I have my complete NeoVim setup here up and running. So there are some errors down here, but that's due to the fact that I don't have a node font installed. So we'll do that in a minute. And I have all my keyboard shortcuts here and all the plugins and everything is working here on NeoVim. So I will just quit here. And now I will just add a new file to the desktop feature sets and name this one fonts.nix. And here we do basically the same thing we did with the other feature sets. So we have a shorthand for our config features, desktop fonts, and then we create an enable option. And here we just install the fonts that are parts of the Nix packages. So I install FireCode, FireCode symbols, FireCode NerdFont, font manager as a GUI font management application, yeah, and just two other fonts I am using regularly. So just save this one. And of course, we need to get to our host definition here and just say fonts.enable equals true. And here on the desktop folder, we need to import fonts.nix. Save this one, add it to our repo. And now we can try to rebuild our system configuration. And this has built successfully. And when we go back to our virtual machine, kill Hyperland and log in again, you can see this has also fixed the symbols on our waybar. And when we enter the terminal and enter NeoVim and open the file tree, you can see we got the symbols here, and here we can just open our configuration. This is working fine now, so we can just quit this one. And as you can see, we also have Font Manager available as defined in our configuration here. So the way you would prepare this Git repo for the .files is actually how you would use it in your .config folder. So you just have the subfolders for your different applications and you just put in the regular files you would put into your .config application name folder. So that's basically it, and that's a very easy and straightforward way to do it. What I also would like to show you is how you can just build simple config files within your home manager and Nix configuration. So within our .files folder, for example, I just create a one for bat.nix. And here I can just define home.file.config/bat. Here we just name the file config. And here we just add .text. And now we can just give it a multi-line string, so we could just copy and paste the contents we would normally put into a config file for our bat. So in this case, I take the Dracula theme and I define line numbers, changes, and header here for bat. This part is not necessary because we don't use anything from config here. And in the default.nix file, we need to add imports here, and we just import bat.nix, and now add everything to our Git repo and rebuild the system. And now when I head back to my virtual machine and enter the terminal, take this here, and here you can see the color theme is applied, and we also have the line numbers shown here. And of course, we can have a look at bat config. And here you can see that we have successfully written out the config file for bat in this case. I realized that I didn't really talk about the reason why we would use the .files repo as a flake input. The thing is, really, each time we update our flake, Nix will automatically fetch the latest version of the Git repo automatically, so we don't have to pull it each time manually. And to make this even more practical, we can also just update the input for our .files without updating the whole flake, because when we update the whole flake, this will also update Nix packages, and this might cause a longer build or download time. So let me show you what I mean. So just let me clear this one and make it a little bit bigger. And let's say I make change to my init.lua file here and just make a small addition, save it and commit the changes to my repo, push it up to the server. And when I want to synchronize my .files to the virtual machine, for example, I can just go here and just update the input for the .files. So I can just use the command nix flake lock and then use the flag update input and just the name of the input I want to update. So when I hit enter here, you can see that Nix has fetched the latest commit of my .files repo. And that's really the advantage here. I only have to take care that I commit my changes on my .files and push it up to the remote repo. And when I want to synchronize it on a system, I can just update the single flake input for the .files. So I don't need to make any package changes to the system or update any other packages, and just do a quick rebuild for the system or just with home manager, and I am up to date with my program settings. So what we have done basically when it comes to .files in NixOS, we have kind of used three different ways to build .files for your user configuration. At first we had Hyperland, and we also had Waybar, where we used Nix to build up a flexible configuration. So in the waybar example, it's just partially because, as you can see here, we have written out the CSS just as a multi-line string, but the actual configuration is written in Nix. And the same we did for Hyperland to achieve a more flexible configuration. And what we also did, we have defined a new input with our Dotfiles repo and used it in our Dotfiles here to recursively import the configuration for NeoVim. And the third way was the last one I showed you, where we just manually created a config file. With this method, you can basically put a file anywhere. This doesn't have to be a configuration file. This could also be a script or whatever you want to have in some place. But for example, when it comes to shell scripts you use regularly, it makes really more sense to package them up. But I will show you that in a later video. So that's it for today. I'm not quite sure what to do in the next video. Probably I will show you how to make a NixOS installation and apply the Flake configuration immediately, so you can see that it's possible to actually build a whole system out of the configuration. And afterwards, I will probably move to my real computer, because as of right now, I have a configuration I can work with now. I just need to make a couple of tweaks. And yeah, then we can move away from the virtual machine, which is not the best place to work with Hyperland. So that's it from me today. If you have questions, just drop a comment. And yeah, please like and subscribe. Have a nice day. Bye.